present is a product of our past. Just like a fruitful future stares at what we do in the present. It's the prudence and vision that lay a path of progress and keep the humanity prospering. In David McCullough's words, history is who we are and why we are the way we are. In 1851, Isaac Singer was granted a patent for his sewing machine, which empowered generations to come. The same year, New York Times started their publication, which heralded a new revolution in the print universe. While the world was taking rapid strides in growth, in India during the same time, a pioneering institute in geosciences was incepted. Geological Survey of India, GSI. Established on 4th March 1851, Geological Survey of India was founded by Sir Thomas Oldham in Kolkata. He broadened the scope of GSI from just coal exploration to mapping the geological landscape of India and assessing other mineral resources. In 1867, he presented 16 memoirs on coalfields of India depicting the possibilities of growth with scientific approach. A couple of years later, in 1869, the Great Cutchin earthquake led Sir Thomas Oldham to initiate earthquake studies in GSI. This study is regarded as one of the classic treatises that opened new vistas in observational seismology. The year was 1875 when Geological Survey of India's headquarters building came up in Kolkata. The building is the epicenter of geological research and development, contributing immensely to the economic progress of India. 1880 was a landmark year in India's geological history, as Dr. P. N. Bose became the first Indian to hold a graded position in GSI. He was the first person to introduce the study of microsections as an aid to petrological work. At the end of the 19th century, in 1890, GSI drew the geological map of India covering Afghanistan and Burma. In 1909, with the help of engineering geology, railway line was introduced in a colliery in salt range for coal transportation. Post-independence in 1951, while GSI celebrated its centenary year, it took rapid leaps to being a contributor towards building a new India. This was a special year for the Indian geological fraternity, since in the same year, Dr. M. S. Krishnan became the first Indian to be appointed as the director of GSI. The year was 1962, and to explore the Earth's physical and magnetic properties, GSI introduced the Geophysics Division. 2 years later, in 1964, GSI had the privilege of hosting the 22nd International Geological Congress, IGC session in New Delhi, as India became the first Asian country to host this prestigious conference. In 1965, GSI deep dived into the sea exploration to research and discover the resources available beneath the sea. Thus, Marine and Coastal Division, MCSD, division was set up. In the same decade, in 1967, the Remote Sensing and Aerial Survey Division, formerly known as AMSE Wing, was established with a wider activity domain. This airborne survey aided in mapping, mineral targeting, geoenvironmental hazard assessment, and geoengineering solutions. In 1972, to focus on the systematic exploration of minerals, Mineral Exploration Corporation Limited, MECL, was carved out of GSI. 1974 was another gem of a year. To bring transparency and standardization in gem testing facility at Gemology Division, Kolkata was established in this year. With advancement in geological exploration, it created a need for highly skilled geologists. Thus, in 1976, GSI Training Institute, GSITI, was established in Raipur. This institution was set up for training and capacity building to increase the efficiency and talent in the geological sector. It has expanded its operation across different geological terrains of the country by diversifying its activities, establishing field training centers, and in the process, has shifted its headquarters to Hyderabad. Since 1982, GSI has been at the forefront of polar studies in the form of geoscientific research in Antarctic region. The same year it participated in its first Indian Antarctic expedition. In 1983-84, India's first permanent research station, Dakshin Gangotri, was set up in Antarctica as a part of the Indian Antarctic program. In 1985, GSI saw the future and harnessed the power of dot-com boom. It initiated its IT journey with implementation of DOS system. In the same year, a dedicated center, Antarctica Division, was established in GSI at Faridabad, Haryana for Antarctic studies. In 1992, as a part of its ground surveys program, to map the entire region of the country, GSI launched the specialized theme-oriented large-scale mapping 1:25,000 under the specialized thematic mapping program. At the start of the 21st century, in 2001, GSI celebrated its 150th year of its glorious journey. In the same year, National Geochemical Mapping Program was launched to advance the ground survey activity. In 2002-2003, it launched the National Geophysical Mapping Program to enhance the ground survey activity. 2004 was a landmark year in GSI's history. It was declared as the nodal agency for landslide studies in India. As they say, change is the only constant. Thus, in 2010, GSI was restructured by Cabinet-approved High Power Committee, HPC, to expand its horizons. In 2012, in accordance with the High Power Committee, HPC, recommendations, the Regeneration Matrix mode was implemented to improve the operations of GSI. With an aim to expand the fundamental geosciences research, as part of the Mission 4, recommended by High Power Committee, three National Center of Excellence in Geological Research Centers were set up. This was established in 2013 in Kolkata, Bengaluru, and Faridabad. In 2016, the launch of the Beta Go Live version of Online Core Business Integrated System, OCBIS, was a pivotal moment in terms of GSI technological advancement. The GSI portal with this technology provides a single point window access for information and service requirements. In 2018, GSI was declared as the nodal agency for collection, curation, registration, and dissemination of all the meteorite falls and finds within the Indian territory. The GSI started its journey in the British ruled India with an aim to explore coal that was utilized for their transportation needs. GSI has recognized the consequences of fossil fuels on the environment. Thus, with an aim for a sustainable future, it has focused its attention to renewable non-conventional forms of energy resources such as geothermal hot springs. The GSI journey has evolved from being a mere coal exploration agency to attain the status of one of the best premier geological institutes in the world.